What's going on, guys? Welcome to a Modern Masters draft on Channel Fireball. So been doing pretty well in this format. Last three nights, I've went 8-1, 8-1, 6-0 in matches for Modern Masters 2. I feel like I have a pretty good handle on the format. I've done about probably 30 drafts. So right here, we either have Vampire Knight or Cyclonic Rift. I think Cyclonic Rift is the stronger card. I think it's close. I also think being single blue is better than double black. And I also think, as you know, along with what the popular opinion is that Dimir is the best color in this format. So it's weird passing either of these cards, but if I have to pass something, I'm probably going to pass the Nighthawk, and that's a weird feeling. However, now we have a Compulsive Research, which is nice. Other options are Rocks War Monk, which is great, but it's three colors. Grizzly Spectacle, which is nice to have. I don't think it's one of the... there's so many 4-drops in this set. This deck is like 75%, or this format's like 75% 4-drops. It's like, you'll have like 1 card, 3 cards, 2 cards, 8 cards, 2 cards. That's how it's going to look, if you guys understand what I'm saying here. Yeah, so we're just going to take the Compulsive Research. It keeps us blue. And if we get anything that's like super good, like a Dimir Signet, well, that's super weird. Dimir being, like we said, one of the best color combinations in the format. And I would first pick Signets over most things, just because the ramp is so crucial to ramp you from 2 to 4, as we mentioned. Nothing else in this pack really gets me. I think Thornscape Battlemage is one of the unsung heroes in this format. Being able to kill a Golem and a Splicer, or Golem and anything else, or a Signet and something else is just huge. But I'm going to take the Dimir Signet because obvious reasons. And I'm probably going to take the Orzhov Signet here as well. So now someone gets Thornscape Battlemage into Woolly Thokdar, so that's nice for them. And then there's also this Jungle Shrine. But yeah, we're just going to take the two Signets, and maybe we'll be Esper, I guess. Because if you're passing me these two Signets, that's pretty good. Now I'm going to take the Guild Gate. There's nothing else in here that we're really concerned with. Maybe Momentary Blink. We don't have any creatures that are... I'm going to take the Momentary Blink, actually. I kind of like that better here. We don't have any blinkable guys, but we could actually just be blue-white as well. And we could always get blinkable guys. If we don't get any blinkable guys, then I feel bad for our deck in general, so... unfortunately, two red... Red Guild Gates. And Pitkeeper is actually a card that has grown on me quite a bit. In the late game, it's just great. It's just a guy that gets back your other guys. If you can blink it with something like Momentary Blink, it's also very good. I've even Unburial Rites to Pitkeeper to get back another Pitkeeper to get back something else before, which is not terrible. And also, Pitkeepers are better in multiples. And I'm pretty sure we can get all of these cards at some other point. I'm going to grab the Pitkeeper here. No, I'm going to grab the Forbidden Alchemy just because it does keep us on color. We might not even be black. But then we have another Forbidden Alchemy, and I just don't want that. I'm going to take this Talon Trooper. That guy's a reasonable gentleman. Oh, a late Azorius Guildgate. Yeah, I'll definitely take that. Other options are Eyes in the Sky. But this is not the Esper deck, or even the blue-white deck by itself. It's not usually a token deck. So, we'll just take the Guild Gate and see what happens. Sensor Splicer or Jailbreaker. Since we don't have that many blue cards, we do have, or that many black cards, which is none, and we do have a Momentary Blink, I'm going to take the Splicer here. I like Gift of Orzhova. Gift is interesting. Same way Unflinching Courage is interesting. A lot of these cards are... The effect is great. Lifelink is great at pulling you back into the game. They could be... They're very susceptible to removal, obviously. But I think having one gift is probably better than a grasp this early. I do like grasp, though. Yeah, let's go with grasp. I changed my mind pretty quickly there. None of these cards are... I'm probably not going to play a second Forbidden Alchemy. Not a big Aether Toe fan. But these are the only playables in the pack. I'll just take the Aether Toe, I guess. Oh, Jailbreaker. Okay, so that's pretty good. And... just take Web. I actually kind of like Agent of Masks. I think this in the slow grindy stalls, like, it's actually a reasonable card. I'm gonna take the Agent of Masks here. And the last pick, Spell Pierce, is just great for us. I am okay with that. And a Wart, unfortunately not playable for us. Another gift. The pick is definitely either Soul Ransom or Agony Warp here. I think it's actually Soul Ransom. I think Soul Ransom is a fantastic card. Worst case scenario, they get their guy back. And how do they do that? They discard two and you draw two for four mana. It seems pretty good. So, yeah, we're going to take the Soul Ransom here. And now we're taking Miss Meadow Witch, because in this format, this is a card you don't pass. Miss Meadow Witch is able to just take over games. And if we can get any Mist Ravens or Denrova Horrors, we're in real good shape. So, Miss Meadow Witch is just game. It's game breaking. It takes over games. And now we're going to take this Arcane Sanctum because it's perfect for us. Ranger of Eos is not great in this format. You get things like Wing Splicers and Soul Wardens. Maybe. Don't care about Core Skyfisher. I don't actually love the idea of the tempo loss returning a thing to your hand. If you return like a Sensor Splicer, it's fine. But then you're playing this guy on turn 6. So I'd rather just have the fixing that's all three of our colors right now. The Tricolor Guildgate. Man, unfortunately, I didn't want to. I actually consciously went into this draft trying not to be blue, black. But then we open Vampire Nighthawk and Arid Mesa. Then we open Vampire Nighthawk and Cyclonic Rift. And we don't get the option. Arid Mesa is like 6 tickets. It also lets us splash a red. Otherwise, I'd probably take the Arcane Sanctum, but man, do I just take the Arid Mesa, guys? Would you hate me if I took the Arid Mesa? I do like Grizzly Spectacle a lot, but it's double black, and I don't really feel like I want to be double blacking if I don't have to. It's weird that the Arid Mesa is still here. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Mesa. I'm not even going to feel bad about it. Talon Trooper is pretty good. If we were going to take it last pack, we can probably take it this pack. I'm not a big Attendant Knight fan. Maybe it's good with Miss Meadow Witch, though, just to be blinking, but I think I'd just rather have the 2-3 Flyer. I'd rather have the card that's better on its own than the card that's better with Miss Meadow Witch, so. Interestingly enough, we are basically seeing very, very few black cards and no good blue cards anymore. Our first pack was great, but they seem to have dried up. So now we have like all these good green cards like Ground Assault, Call to Conclave, and Sylvan Ranger, which is interesting. Could just take Mystical Teachings, but what do we even get with Mystical Teachings? A Forbidden Alchemy or a Cyclonic Rift or a Momentary Blink. Like those are we have three cards for Mystical Teachings here, so I'm not thrilled about it. I guess we can take Rootborn Defenses. But then we have one creature that makes a token. I'm just going to take the Pilfered Plans because it's a way to draw cards. At least there's picks here. Wall of Frost is fine, and then we have that Gift of Orzhova that we were looking at earlier. One thing about the blue-black decks is that you can kind of like pick apart their hand with things like Entombed Exarch or Night Terrors. Or you can just wait out their removal until they kill all your things, and then they'll have like one or two cards in hand, and you can kind of tell that it's not removal. And then you can just play Gift of Orzhova if you have it. Wall of Frost might be better here. Maybe we're playing the Wall of Frost go over your head deck, which seems kind of good. Again, like we don't look like we're heavy black at all, which is nice. Put the Air Mace over there. Guys gotta eat. we'll take Spire Monitor here. Seems fine. Oh, and we get a Gift of Orzhova if we want one. I do think we're taking the gift here over the Talon Trooper. Maybe. Ah, oh, God, I still kind of want to pass it. I'm just still not sold on it. Like, I think the other cards are more impactful. I even think having a Night Terrors in the deck would be great. I'm going to take the Talon Trooper here. It just blocks all the other guys. Like, all the 2-2s. We'll take Attendant Knight. We'll have one. It's better than Rootborn Defenses for us. Pilfered Plans, I'm not going to play two. And Kraken Hatchling is good for the sideboard, but we might just play Attendant Knight, so. And Crippling Chill is fine. Mm, None of these cards are super interesting. We'll just take... just take Seal, I guess. I'm gonna put the Agent in the main deck, just in case. With Triple Talon Trooper and Attendant Knight, I can even see... And Wall of Frost, I can even see the Aether Toe. I don't think I've ever actually played Aether Toe in this format. That is a late Penumbra Spider. We could actually take the Sky Knight Legionnaire and splash it off the Arid Mesa. Actually, I like Gnawing Zombie. Not because it's super exciting, but being a 1-3 is pretty relevant in this format. It blocks all the other 3-1s and the 2-2s, so... Now we need some Mist Ravens and some Denrova Horrors here. Can we get those? I will take an Extractor Demon. That guy is good. I hate passing an Orzhov Signet, but two Signets is nice, and Extractor Demon is pretty ridiculous. He's just a 5-5 that's... It's a 5-5 flyer. Like, nothing else really needs to be said, so... I also like Seagate Oracle. Maybe Seagate Oracle will come back. Probably not. I can't imagine there are 7 better cards than Seagate Oracle in that pack. So everything else in our deck, I think, is pretty playable right now. There's none of these cards I'm like, oh, I hate this card. I think the close cuts right now are the Toe, Agent of Masks. Attendant Knight, Momentary Blink's not great for us here yet. We do have a second Soul Ransom, but I think I want a first Mist Raven before I want a second Soul Ransom. Yeah, I think it's Mist Raven here. Like, the problem with Soul Ransom is sometimes they have, like, let's say you're playing against the aggressive token deck, and they have 3 goblin tokens. Like, Mist Raven's obviously just better in that position. It gives you a blocker, and it's a creature you actually care about rather than don't care about. It also blinks well with Momentary Blink. Man, these green cards are unreal. We also have an Izzet Signet and a Golgari Signet. Not sure if we care about the splash at all here. I think it might just be Hookmaster. Man. I think Hookmaster's probably better than Attended Knight. Attended Knight? I've also played Teleportal quite a few times to success. The card is just fantastic. It comes out of nowhere, and there's not much they can do about it. You just get, like I said, you get into these stally situations, these ground stalls, and then you're just like, alright, I'll just kill you on this turn. I don't think I care about Hookmaster here. I think I'm gonna take the Teleportal, and maybe we board it in? Maybe? Maybe? Another Woolly Thoctar. Our Naya deck would be just ridiculous. Just ridiculous. I'm gonna take the Dimir Guildgate. Makes our mana a little better. Grixis Slave Driver is kind of meh. Opportunity is pretty nice, though. Usually I'm not a huge fan of Opportunity, but we don't have much of a top end here, and I'm pretty okay with taking a draw 4 here. I'm going to take this Opportunity to take Opportunity. I love Ogre Jailbreaker, but I might just take the Sensor Splicer because we have Momentary Link. Maybe? And we only have 2 Guildgates, so I think actually Splicer's the better pick here. So, let's take it. Okay, so Vanish into Memory is a super interesting card. I have not personally played it, but it's been played against me several times, and it's been a ridiculous, like, pretty much a blowout. If you can blink a Worm token, a Slime token, or a, you know, an Elephant or a Golem... You draw 3 or 4 cards, and then they lose their creature forever. It's pretty insane. So I think I'm actually just going to take the Vanish here. I do like Wall of Denial, and I also like Core Hookmaster, but I kind of want to try this. So we're going to see how this goes in our draft. I actually like Rakdos Signet here if we're planning on splashing the Teleportal. We also have Arid Mesa to get a... Plus, we also, this is like, move these lands over here. This is 26 cards, and Signet could let us play one less land. Unfortunately, I don't think there's anything that uses, like, eh, we can move the Crippling Chill. We also have, like, very few 2-drops. Yeah, this is fine. I think Rakdos Signet's the pick here. And an Orzhov Signet. Good lord. Alright, let's just take the other Signet. I don't know why these are still here. And then I can't even right now, guys. I'm sorry. This is too many Signets. 5 Signets is a little too much, I think. Ugh. Is this Augur? Is it Recover? Might be Recover here. I do like Recover a lot. Because it draws you a card and it gets back. There's so many good creatures that you kind of want to get back. I mean, get back like Extractor Demon or even Sensor Splicer is very good. These Signets are just ridiculous. Let's take Golgari Signet. Yeah, take another Spider. I actually was hoping a Bone Splinters would come back because we don't actually have a tremendous amount of removal. And alright, so this is our... Alright, let's see what we're cutting here. This format's a little more interesting. Like, usually when I'm drafting, like, a normal set, like, a standard set, the deck is pretty much built by the end, but you keep getting good playable cards in this format till the very end. So it's a little harder to have your deck exactly built. I might cut the Rakdos Signet unless we board in Teleportal. Because I think 3 Signets is more than reasonable. I think we can cut the Aether Toe. We can probably cut Agent of Masks here. And I think with 3 Signets, we can probably get away with 15 lands, especially when we don't have that high of a curve. 13 creatures. Probably don't want to cut another creature. I'm not actually sold on Bone Splinters here, but then again, we do have Attendant Knight. We could sacrifice Sensor Splicers if we want to. Momentary Blink is just a removal spell. Or a counter spell, rather, for removal. Like, if they try to kill, like, a Talon Trooper, we can just blink it. I think it's pretty reasonable. I do like Recover. We have a lot of card advantage now. We have Opportunity, Vanish into Memory, Recover, Compulsive Research, and Forbidden Alchemy. I think I could see cutting the Forbidden Alchemy. We don't have a lot of cards that are great in the graveyard other than Grasp and Momentary Blink. I would not consider Extractor Demon good in the graveyard. I kind of want the 5/5 on board and the mill ability to be relevant. I don't think we actually need Forbidden Alchemy here. And I think this is probably the deck, the 15 land 3 Signet deck, which is just fine. Guildgate, Arcane Sanctum. Sort by color. Unfortunately, got no Denrova Horrors, which is, as you guys probably know, the best common in the set. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 8 black sources. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 10 blue sources. Probably got on a 9 here. And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is 9, 8, 8. Which I'm pretty comfortable with. I'm okay with double black, because we have a double black spell. We want the most blue. So we have 9, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, that seems good. Alright, so we'll see you guys in round 1.